Hello, everyone, and welcome to Race 9 of the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series Season 2 here at the Dirt Resurfaced Papyrus Motorsport Park. I'm joined tonight in the booth by Giancarlo Iorenda
Drivers, start
and
your
Jameson O'Monkey. Say hi, everyone.
Hi,
Boy,
everyone.
howdy. Boy, howdy. Boy, howdy. Boy, howdy. Boy, howdy.
We've already got our first heat race lined up, and already we have some issues rolling off the start in the back. There's General Jake in the Sonic Mania 20 car pulling off to the access row. Not a great start here for the 20 car.
No, I wouldn't mind.
Definitely not what you want to see.
But now we have our overall event pole sitter, our race winner from 2 races ago. That's a 38 of Nate Lines. And starting on his outside, that would be the 55 of James O'Mackie. So a pretty great lineup here for our first heat race at the 7-turn, 3-plus-mile high-banked road course. As Nate Wines, our pole sitter, are going to take us into the Geico restart zone. The green flag to kick off dirt racing action here today in Papyrus. 3 laps here for this very first heat race.
Here we go, baby. High banks, high turns. Gonna have a lot of speed here.
Into turn number two we go. Here comes Don Falconer trying to make it 3 wide for second as Nate Wines continues to grow his gap for the lead. KR looking on the bottom, try to get some speed. And there's Lucy Fife as well. Last race's winner at Flemington, looking for third.
Trying to go 3 wide here. This track's pretty narrow. I'm not sure that's going to work out too well for anybody involved in that.
Get to our first bank corner here. You see the upper groove where the dirt is darker? That is where all the moisture is. And the more moisture there is, the grippier your car is going to be. So expect some of the high line coming out of action here. As KR, who took that upper groove, now just passed 2 race cars down that straightaway.
Such a powerful move, and I think we're going to see a lot of drivers try to implement that today.
To James O'Mackie with a run down the straightaway.
Might be looking to the inside here. Definitely has the run.
That's what he's doing.
Nate tried to pull the block. The window closed just before he could get there. Smart move to pull away before he caused an accident.
It looks as though the door has officially opened for the entire inside lane as Omaki's bringing a whole bunch of cars with him as they try to get past the 38.
Nate Wines losing considerable ground as James O'Mackie delayed, and almost immediately Don Falconer is going to peak low. Almost faked him out there a little bit, and now he's to the bottom of O'Mackie for the lead.
These guys are teammates.
I say are. Well, technical teammates. They are technically aligned, but they do run out of different organizations. But yeah, or I'm wrong. I don't know. We'll figure that out.
I'm pretty sure they both draft for OKAR.
Oh, they do. I don't know. I thought Don Falconer owned his own team. I'd remembered differently. I don't know. It's fine.
It's all
as
right.
almost in contact in
Oh,
that upper groove, the 38 and the 5 running into each other, almost taking out Zach Stern in the process.
Nate
As now
Wines
we
is
see,
really squirrely. Oh, and the fence goes down.
was able to ride the momentum on that outside groove to keep that lead. As now Amaki's going to have that top groove, but Don Falconer's going to clear him either way.
Amaki putting himself in the wall there, going down the straightaway, didn't do himself any favors. But by the looks of it, he's going to come out of the neck this corner, side by side with the 66 of Don Falconer. It's going to be a dead
Don
heat
Falconer
going
can
down
get
the
the run,
straightaway.
taking that home.
Diving into turn six here. Falconer is going to clear his teammate for the lead once again. I apologize, it's actually turn seven now. O'Mackie with a run as we're going to head to the front straightaway.
Maki on this back section just seems to be really fast. We'll see if he can implement that later on.
Keep your eyes on that 85 of KR, always fast. Always one to look
White
out
flag.
for.
More time around. O'Mackie's got a run. He's going to look low on Don Falconer.
I'm talking here again, try to throw the block, just like Nate Wines did again, moved out of the way just in time. What's
Into
KR
two,
do here?
O'Mackie. O'Mackie getting the lead. KR's looking for second. See, Nate Wines outside of the transfer spot. He finds himself battling with Logan Speed right now. Very interesting circumstances for our pole sitter.
Really just a tough pill to swallow, just having the lead early and just falling all the way back. It's demoralizing for a driver.
Amaki has cleared the 66 of Falconer, and now it appears as though the 66 now has the 85 of KR to deal with. All the while, the 5 of Lucy Fife is slowly making her way back towards this pack, potentially going to challenge for the top 3 podium position.
Oh, she is.
I believe that's Lucy Fago driving that.
Every position here is an extra point. Every position is 4 extra better starting spots. In the main event, now we see Dawn Falconer with a big run heading into 7. He's going to look low on his teammate.
See what James does here if he tries to block. It's too late.
Side by side going into this corner. The 66 currently has the advantage. Will the 55 be able to do anything about it?
I don't think so.
Off of turn 7, Falconer is going to clear his teammate. And as they come to the stripe, it is going to be Dawn Falconer taking the win in heat race number 1.
Great racing.
Oh, great finish for that heat race. Wow. As now we see Omaki. Now he, as well as Omaki, KR, Lucy Vago, and it looks like Zach Stern will also make that heat race in the main event in the final spot, as Nate Wines is going to have to go through the B main.
Big run today for Tower Racing, trying to get some momentum.
Again, action-packed first heat race here at the Papyrus Motorsports Park. We'll be back for more. Alright, welcome back to our second heat race here in Papyrus Motorsports Park. This time it will be Paul Donlin on the number 7 Google machine with the pole with Tanner Campos to his outside.
Got Mooch behind him, Quinn Yeager.
That'll be Kylie Grider in the 29.
I'm sorry, that is Kylie Grider. My apologies. Kayla Marinelli there in the 15, and then the 17 of Kyler Scott behind, out to his outside.
Round out your first 3 rows. Paul Donlin, with an amazing stroke of luck, or rather speed, in the Millennium NASCAR Cup Series. And let's see how that transfers over to the Dirt Series, as he will lead the rest of this Heat 2 field to our green flag for his second heat race in Papyrus.
Paul Donlin has been nothing but dominating up in the Cup Series. We'll see if he can transfer that down here.
Out of turn number 1, looks like Alan Mook is going to look low. Paul Don's going to be right on that high side with Tanner Campos right behind him. Caleb Marinelli looking to gain some speed on that bottom as well.
Oh, yeah. 2 wide, 3 rows back. That's what you'll have to see. You know, I look at a guy like Paul Donlin. You know who he reminds me of? He reminds me of Jean Girard.
Oh, and he's going to move him up the track. 3 wide. Tanner Campos on the bottom now.
Tanner Campos going to get the move. Nobody's really going to get that run off. Maybe Paul will get some of that moisture, see if he can get a run through there.
Yes, he does. He's going to clear him, as now Paul Donlin really sideways heading up the racetrack. They're still going to be side by side through 6.
Well, I moved down to the inside for the 44 of Campos. It looks as though they're going to be a side by side heading down this main straightaway. Here they come.
We'll have to see how this moisture develops throughout the race, but so far, that high line is definitely the way to go through those corners.
Out of turn 7, it will be the number 7, leading the field onto the front straightaway. Tanner Campos right behind him. Kylie Grider up to 3rd with Alan Mooch and Caleb Marinelli rounding out the transfer positions.
Pretty to be expected set of transfer guys so far. Not really anybody that you wouldn't expect to be there.
Now through 2, Tanner Campos stuck on that bottom line. Here comes his teammate, Kylie Grider. He's going to try to take second.
Oh, she goes high. Oh, whoa, 3-1.
Kyle Mooch going to go low.
He's going to force Kylie high into that groove. We'll see if that hurts Talon or helps him.
Kind of have a little bit of run now.
Kylie's going to get all that speed right back through that moisture.
Tanner's going to look a little bit low into turn number 6. He's going to be really slow on entry.
Tanner Campbell's just been struggling through these turns. He's going to have to make an adjustment for the main.
Paul Dolan seems to be pulling away with that race lead, with Kylie Grattor now looking for second on her teammate as the main battle right now.
The moment, a complete inverse of what happened in the first heat with our pole sitter from that event, Nate Wines, falling backwards through the field and now stuck outside of the A main, while the 7 of Paul Dolan continues to lead right now and looks as though it's an easy lock for winning this heat and transferring.
White flag. One more lap to go.
See if anybody can make a move here. Alan Mooch looking on Kylie Grattor right now.
Tanner Campos trying to close that gap once again between himself and Paul Donlan. Alan Mooch looking for third on Kylie Grattor. Caleb Marinelli seems to have slipped back. Though he's still in the main event for now.
Alan Mooch really trying to be aggressive, go to the bottom. I wonder when he's going to figure out that the bottom lane isn't the way to go through this area.
Paul Dolan going to run a little bit higher than the cars behind him. See that fares out of the corner. Got to make sure you don't hit that wall as well, as both drivers seem to do that. But Tanner's going to get a little bit of a run now.
Alan Mooch was the only one of those top four that didn't hit the wall. But had to check up to avoid Kylie, so that really didn't matter.
Paul Dolan running really far up, and he's going to get the big run because of that.
Kylie looking to the bottom on Tanner here. I believe this is through 7.
Through the final corner. Out of turn number 7 in our second heat race today. Out of turn 7, it will be the number 7 of Paul Dolman taking the 5 points and our second heat race win in Papyrus. But Tanner got a little bit of run there. I think he just ran out of straightaway.
Absolutely. I would have seen that go another lap. That might have been a pass.
Oh, yeah.
Unfortunate showing for Brandon. He's going to have to go to the B main.
And as well, Kyler Scott, our points leader, just a few races ago, also going to have to go to the B main here momentarily.
As are Quinn Jaeger and Colin Dover.
Yes, sir. And making the main event will be Paul Donlan, Tanner Campos, Kylie Grattor, Alan Mooch, and Kayla Marinelli. Second heat race concluded with a Paul Donlan victory. We'll be back for more right after the break. All right, welcome back, everybody, to the Papyrus Motorsport Park for our third heat race of the day. This time it's going to be Ethan Farley and his MRE machine taking the pole for this one. Caden Bishop, with the recent brink speed, has got two of his teammates in this heat race. He'll start on the front row, and the third row will be the brink teammates of Kyler Suthry and Seth Peters. We'll see how they do.
You also have Justin Newman up in there.
We saw one heat where pole sitter fell back through the field and is now stuck in the beam. And we had at our most recent heat with our pole sitter taking it all. We'll see what happens in this one.
There you go through the Geico restart zone. The zero of Ethan Farley is going to mash the gas. We're going to go back to the green here. At Papyrus, and a great restart for that outside lane, but Justin Newman racing no time, making it three wide for the lead on the bottom.
I think Ethan Farley just had a bad jump off the start.
That's what it seemed to be.
He's going to get eat up by these two.
And a big move by Justin Newman. He's going to be in the lead, and it's Caden Bishop running right by that wall.
Yeah, look out for Kyler Sustra. He's coming.
Now here's Sustry on that top side. Seth Peters is going to look low. They're going to be three wide for second. Sustry's going to drop back.
A lot of momentum lost there for the one car, and that's going to force him backwards into the grass, so I can't quite make out who that is. But,
oh, just a mini hard in the wall. I believe that other guy's a 54 of Ian Stiles.
Yeah, 54 of Ian Stiles replacing passed away from last race. Jackson Traeger, an unfortunate incident at the Flemington Speedway.
Big sad.
Ian Stiles ain't doing half bad.
No, he isn't, but I mean, we haven't held a single memorial for Jackson Traeger, so we'll see how that shapes up. We kind of don't really care about him, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm about to say. Out of turn seven, it's going to be Justin Newman leading our first lap. Not if Ethan Farley has anything to say about it, though.
I'm not sure if he's got enough run. He does, as Justin Newman puts himself on the fence, though.
He literally just did that, and now here comes Farley to the point.
And Bishop's on his way back on the bottom as well. That's a huge surge of momentum for the 37 car. Here he comes, coming out, if I believe. Is that turn one or turn two? I don't know.
That would be turn one, and at turn two we are now.
Aiden Bishop and those Brink cars got a lot of speed as of late.
Justin Newman going to dip his tires in that moisturized groove up there. You get a little bit of run now.
I'm looking heavily at that transfer battle between Ian and Sustry right now.
Styles is doing a terrific job keeping track of this lead group. Is not letting Sustry out of his sights. That being said, it looks as though, in the carrying on for the last heat, it looks as though passing is going to be a bit of a Travis as multiple cars in the wall coming off of the turn.
Now Caden Bishop right through the fuel cell of that zero of Ethan Farley. Farley's going to run up in that dirt groove up there. Get a little bit of speed off the corner. Justin Newman's going to look low again.
I wonder how many people here are going to adjust between the heats and the main, trying to maybe get a little less engine power, because it seems like everybody's just overdriving these corners.
A big run from Caden Bishop as we come to the white flag right now. Justin Newman's going to look three wide, really low once again. Here we go on the turn number one and a repeat of the very first lap.
Oh, here they go. Whoa, get squirrely.
Remain three wide into turn number two now. Caden Bishop from the middle line is going to take the lead away.
Wow, that power. Ian Stiles falling back. He's these top five cars under a blanket. I'm not sure the transfer spots are going to change unless something dramatic happens.
No, sorry.
Kyler Sustry trying to make it a 1-2 finish here for Brink here.
He's in the wall, though. He's still going to get a run. He's going to be trapped, though, between the 0 and the 19. Probably going to have one more shot on the 37 here.
He's not going to get there. I think the one's going to try and battle him, keep him off of the 37.
Oh, but he's in the wall. And now here comes Sustry.
Sustry's going to have the preferred lane going into 7.
He's
going
to block him.
Oh, he does throw the block.
Now the 37 of Caden Bishop. Not won a heat race set this season, but out of turn 7, it will be the 37 of Caden Bishop come the line and winning our third heat race of the day. Caden Bishop wins heat race 3 at Papyrus.
That was a magnificent battle that looked like it would have been shaping up for what I believe was the second position, and valiant effort by Ian Stiles on his debut. Regrettably, it was ended up not being enough. He will be making his way to the B main along with the Tickers, Lost Pixels, so I can't make out who those last three are, but along with those last three.
That'd be Ian Stiles, Patrick Quinn guy, Sydney Allen, and Jared Holmes.
As sir, and into the main event will be Heat 3 winner Caden Bishop, Ethan Farley, Kyler Sustry, Justin Newman, and Seth Peters. We'll be back for a final Heat race after this. Welcome back to Papyrus Motorsports Park, everybody, for our final heat race of the evening. There's Evan Taddy, our pole sitter for this heat race. He'll be starting on the inside lane, row one. And the last of the Brink cars, that'll be the 01 of Tyler King. He'll start on the outside with his teammate, actually, Ethan Farley, right behind, not Ethan Farley, Ethan O'Connor behind him.
On the bottom side, you see Carter Jones, you see Dylan Jones.
Roberto Crown will round out that third row on that top lane. Oh, there goes our Amsoil late model series pace truck. Taking that very hard left out of the pit lane. And for the final time, Evan Taddy is going to lead with the green flag for a heat race here in Papyrus, the final heat race of the afternoon.
And a terrific start by that 32. Looks as though he's going to clear the L1, then heading into one. But let's see what the 62 does on the inside lane. And it appears as though Taddy will clear Tyler King.
Big difference between this series and the MLGS. Teammates will not be much of a help to you.
Well, they won't be. There is no bumper there. There's just a roll cage and a fuel cell, so you really can't push in these cars at all now, can you?
Nope. They do more harm than good.
Now, Carter Jones looking to make a move.
Best thing you can do as a teammate is stay right out of the way.
A Ford, a Toyota, and a Chevy in our top three right now. Carter Jones, a little bit of run on Tyler King right now.
Looks high. I think Tyler's going to block and he's going to look low. I'm not sure if he'll have the window. And then Toddy going to get a huge run off this corner running through that moisture coming off six.
Carter Jones with a really big run on the inside of Tyler King.
Really might get him there. Oh, it looks like he will.
Oh, he got him. He's going to clear him off of turn seven right now. Here comes Dylan Jones to the bottom to follow suit.
I'm not sure if that was a great move by Carter or just a really bad move by Tyler.
If you run turn seven just right, you can get a really good run out of it and onto the front straightaway. And now here comes Dylan Jones to second. Evan Taddy, still your race leader. Dylan Jones going to look up high this time. They're going to be three wide. Four, I think that's fourth right now. And that'll determine the final transfer spot.
Held by Carter Jones. Ethan O'Connor currently on the outside looking in. Roberto Crown Jr. has done a tremendous job getting himself back up firmly into the top five. This is going to boost his chances of staying safe dramatically.
Absolutely.
Oh, what up? 62 on the 10.
Oh, no.
Ethan O'Connor and Carter Jones into the wall.
O'Connor.
Here comes Patrick Roden.
What does the 21 do here?
I'm not sure if he got the run yet. We'll go back up to Evan Taddy. He was leading this race with Dylan Jones and Roberto Crown Jr. in tow.
Can I just say this is amazing camera work?
The top four have broken away because of that melee. When we finally cut back to that camera angle, we'll be able to get a better glimpse of the title battle. The title, but yeah, excuse me, the cutoff battle for the transfer spot.
We'll have a replay available at the end of this heat race to review that, as now Evan Tagg is going to come off of turn seven. He's about to take the white flag here, but Dylan Jones has something else to say.
It would appear that way, yes. Trying to go to the bottom. He might just get passed by Roberto here if he's not careful. Red is forced high. Tyler's looking to the bottom.
Dylan Jones had a very rough season so far in the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series, sitting outside the top 20 in points. He could really use a heat race win to build some momentum right now. Roberto Crown Jr. also with a pretty tough season. He's looking to notch off his first heat race win of the year. As now Dylan Jones at the bottom of Evan Taddy, trying
Evan
to take Taddy the lead.
Taddy tells a preferred lane. Here comes Tyler trying to take that preferred lane away from Roberto.
Taddy's into the wall. Dylan Jones is going to block him. He knows that that top line is going to have some speed. And Dylan Jones can get that top line into turn six.
Good, smart move by Dylan Jones there. Block the run, make him force you to go high, and just eat up that moisture.
And he's in the wall hard. They're going to be side by side now.
Not so much
Tyler
for that.
Tyler King looking at the bottom. Three wide through seven.
Three wide through seven on the final lap, final turn. Who's going to win it?
It's going to be a three-way heat coming down the never mind. Jones is backing out. It's going to be a heat between Taddy and Tyler King. Here they come on the final stretch.
Roberto Crown looking low. Tyler King with the run, and it's going to be Tyler King. Side by side, winning heat race number four. O'Connor takes that final transfer spot. Unfortunately, Carter Jones is going to be finishing dead last in that heat race. Not a good start.
An unfortunate.
Again, finishing just outside the top five.
An unfortunate circumstance for Carter Jones. What a dramatic and what a terrific finish to close off that heat. Remarkable.
Fantastic driving by these top four right here. And a spectacular finish. Going to be Tyler King with the win in our final heat race here. Carter Jones got his work cut out for him. That'll be coming up next. Actually, wait, I forgot. We're going to have some replays here for Carter Jones. Here's what happened in a turn three. This is on lap two.
Already entering pretty high, forcing Ethan high. Doesn't have a lot of room to work with.
And that's just too sideways for that 62 car to handle.
Yeah, just entering way too high to try and make that apex of that turn work, especially the guy to your outside. You either want to be at the very top or at the very bottom. You don't really want to be that in between them.
And now coming off of turn six, he hits the wall really badly, and this is what really slows his car down. And that's about the 21 and the 36. Get by him. I don't know if that ended up knocking his axles out of order. But because he finished that race, he'll be allowed to see if he can get it repaired or go to a backup car, if need be, for the B-Main.
I'm not sure that car is going to be fixable before the B-Main.
But yeah, an exciting finish for Tyler King and some hard work ahead for Carter Jones coming up next in our B-Main.
Time and pull on me.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the first of two mains tonight, or this afternoon, rather, for the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series at Papyrus. Nate Wines is going to be our pole sitter for the B main, with Kyler Scott behind him, Ian Thiles in third, Ray Vidagan fourth, and Logan Speed going to be rounding out that transfer spot. And here is Carter Jones. He will be starting this race in the, I think that's the no, that's a 12th position.
Oh, yeah, that...
Either the 12th? I think that's the 12th position, yeah. But anyway, there's our Chevrolet Silverado pace truck making the hard left onto the pit lane. Nate Wines, our winner two races ago, is going to take the green flag here in the B main. Seven here laps around this racetrack.
Here in this LCQ, you really got to put your foot down. You're not allowed to make any mistakes. Everybody will just eat you alive.
At the end of this one, the top five finishers will be racing once again in our main event coming up immediately after this, and everyone else is done for the day. They'll be loading everything up on the trailers and trying to run it back next time we go racing at Williams Grove.
All bumper to bumper here. These top three, I'm looking back at this transfer spot. It's a three-way battle currently.
Nate Wines, the leader. Ian Stiles made his way up to second. Trying to take the lead now.
I believe PQ might get the run off if he doesn't get the door closed on him. He probably will here. He does by David. I'm sorry,
Carter Jones might be the fastest car in this B main. He's already made up some considerable ground here in this event.
He's still got three cars to get around if he wants a transfer spot, though.
Ian Stiles with a run. He's going to look low into seven. Nate Wines going to slam the door on him.
Just so our folks at home understand, is there any points here in this LCQ if you win the race?
No, there will be no points to be earned in this LCQ unless you finish position 6 through 15th, in which case you are done for the day. But the top five do not earn points. They will end up running it back in the main event and seeing how they can there in that event.
See Carter Jones here working on the 30 of Quinn Yeager.
This would be for the transfer spot.
Yes,
Quinn Yeager currently holds that fifth position. Side by side for the lead now. Ian Stiles to the top right now. He's going to try to see what he can do around eight lines. Here comes Kyler Scott.
Well, here it is. That moisture's been starting to fall away as of late, especially if you enter high. We'll see if he can't get any more run out of that moisture. Oh, he's in the wall. That's not going to help.
Carter Jones at the fifth now.
Kyler Scott grazed the wall.
They're going to have runs on Nate Wines right now.
These guys up here, these top three, can't really seem to stay off the wall. It is helping them out a little bit, though.
And there's Carter Jones to fourth.
Nice and Logan Speed for that spot.
Now 62's got a lot of speed under the hood of that 62.
Crazy fast.
And a lap two, Nate Wines will lead it once again. Ian Stiles got some speed. This is his first time racing and several weeks with a replacement driver, was injured at Eldora. First race season was replaced by KR, and then his team owner, Alan Mooch at Cyberstorm, said, you know what? We're going to stick with KR for the remainder of the season. He was left without a ride until he purchased the ownership of JNT Racing after last week. But now he's looking to the bottom for the lead of the B-Main. Oh, and
he's wrecked.
Clips Carter Jones. Oh, and a hard contact from Ray Vidagan.
Oh.
That's going to bring out the caution.
That's unfortunate. That is so unfortunate. This young fellow had a great run going, and just to see it all end like this is just so catastrophic.
Broken smoke for the 54.
That might be the commentator's curse there, folks.
I agree. That was definitely a commentator's curse. I'd like to publicly apologize for Ian Stiles.
Well,
see, they still gotta make their way back to the yellow flag here. But Nate Wines has got himself a bit of a run.
Will this end the LCQ?
This will not. Cautions here are expected to only be about 2 laps, which would give us probably a 3 or 2 lap to go green flag, depending on the cleanup. And our top five, as I come across the yellow flag, will be 30 of Nate Wines, a 17 of Kyler Scott, 62 of Carter Jones, and 91 of Logan Speed, and the 30 of Quinn Yeager. Here's Ian Stiles trying to limp it back to pit road.
I'm very curious about what kind of damage that did to both Carter Jones and I believe it was Logan Speed that he also tagged.
Logan Speed is, or I'm sorry, it was Raven Dagan. Raven Dagan's done for today.
Yeah, Raven Dagan had his engine expired. Nate Wines was a little bit sideways. Not Nate Wines, sorry. Logan Speed was a little bit sideways after that contact, so I don't know if he was able to make that save. I know he just barely grazed by Carter Jones, but there doesn't seem to be any major damage to that 62, as we'll get a look at the replay now.
Did he just send it too hard? Did he get some help? I couldn't tell.
Take a look now. He's trying to get underneath the 38 of Nate Wines, and it's
the exact
mirror image of what happened to Carter Jones in his heat race.
Sending it too hard. You can't do it at a bank track like this. You've got to maintain your composure.
I was going to slide down. He clips Carter just a little bit there. And there's a big contact with Quinn Yeager and then a harder hit from Ray Vidagan.
There's that skull rattler. He's going to be feeling that tomorrow.
Here's an onboard with Carter Jones with the whole incident.
No, yeah, you see that and you just, wow.
Oh, what a save by the 30 of Quinn Yeager to not hit that outside wall. Wow.
Great wheelmanship thing. Yeah, great wheelmanship.
Hmm.
I will ride along with Quinn Yeager if he makes this save.
Times like these, really wish you had a helmet and you could see what their hands are looking like.
Here's Ray Vidagan, he's gonna deliver the biggest hit of all.
Oh yeah, he's all the way down on that paint. There's nowhere he can go.
Yeah.
Unfortunate way to end. Just
in the
surprise fire.
Other Scott was right in front of it when it happened.
Rough circumstance. And here is Nate Wines leading the field as we take you back to our live coverage. And those pace truck lights are off on our Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series Chevrolet Silverado pace truck.
Who's that back in fifth? I can't really tell. It looks like the 20 of General Jake.
Whoever it was, I believe.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and pulling it off, that's Colin Dover with some mechanical troubles.
It's a shame. As I was going to say, it appears as though Quinn Yeager pitted for repairs under that most recent yellow, so it'll be a long trek back up to the top five for that 30 if he even wants to have a remote chance of getting back up into the transfer positions.
Yes, thank you for noting that, Gian. But yeah, he was running so well all day today in that transfer spot almost the entire race, and now he's got to start all the way in the back. Ray Vidagan and Ian Stiles have retired after that incident, though, so they are done for the day.
Unfortunate.
Excuse me.
Nice one. Build single file under the control of the 38 of Nate Wines and to take it to the Geico restart zone. Green flag in the air for Nate Wines. We will have 2 laps to go here at Papyrus.
Kevin team looking at the inside of the 38 here early. Something he could say to the inside, he'd have the preferred lane going into turn three.
Carter Jones is a big one now.
Oh, watch out.
He's looking for a hole through the middle, but it's not there.
By we'll getting
go with Nate Wines on the top side.
Do you think Carter Jones is the type of guy to put the bumper to somebody here?
I'm not sure. We haven't seen him do that, but it wouldn't be beside him, really.
I mean, there's not really much of a reason to do it. Besides just qualifying position, you're already going to be at the back.
Carter Jones ran that bottom.
He's not going to have the runoff, unfortunately. Especially if he puts himself on the fence like that.
Let's see what it does through six.
I feel like I've said that several times before.
Now he's got to run off of turn six.
And there he goes. I guess I spoke too soon.
Looking to the bottom in eight winds through seven.
And force his way down in there.
And he's going to clear him even before corner exit.
White flag getting in the air. Got to have a big ask to try and beat Carter Jones here. Sidney Allen takes over the transfer spot.
Despite getting damaged under the most recent caution, if that caution served as a benefit to anybody, it was most definitely the 62.
Oh, yeah. It was a big gap between himself and the top two spots. Got rid of that gap when they went green, and Carter Jones has been incredibly fast as soon as they took the green flag.
Would you say possibly a chance to win this whole thing?
He's got a lot of work to do starting back. As it stands, he'll start in the 21st position. And he'll have 15 laps to get through the field. But that's if he wins this B main. Nate Wines, we'll see if he has anything for him through 6 and 7.
I don't think he does. I think that NDSU machine is just too fast for anybody else in this LCQ right now.
They'll both run on that top groove trying to get a run off. Carter Jones with a big run off turn 6. And there it is, the number 62 machine. Carter Jones, the NDSU car, coming off of turn 7 for Tau Racing and Chevrolet. He's going to win the B-Main here at Papyrus.
Who's taking the last transfer spot? It is Sidney.
Wow, Sidney Allen. Been really good at silently qualifying for these main events. That'll be a second Allen Motors car in the A-Main. The other one, of course, being the 15 of Caleb Marinelli.
Anyways, don't go away, don't touch that dial, we'll be right back for the A-Main here after this break.
Welcome, everybody, to the main event here at the Papyrus Motorsports Park. This one is for all the marbles here. Don Falconer is going to be your main event pole sitter after his victory in the first heat race with Paul Donlan, Caden Bishop, and Tyler King, your other heat race winners this afternoon. We'll go trackside for the command. And I spoke over it.
God damn it.
And as the field rolls off, we'll take a quick look at today's starting lineup. And here we go. Our Chevrolet Silverado pace truck's going to make that hard left on the pit lane. Don Falconer on the inside, Paul Dolan on the inside. Would the guy go restart zone? The green flag is in the air for 15 laps in our main event here at Papyrus.
Oh, wow. Massive run for Don. Bad start for Donlin.
The entire inside lane appears to have gotten a terrific start as we've got now the top two currently breaking away from the entire field.
Yes, it's Don and Caden breaking away now. Paul Donlin had a terrible restart. However, he does have a lot of power in that car. We'll see if he can bring that back right up.
3x3 throughout most of the field here as they run down the hill.
That's a recipe for disaster.
In turn 5, we'll see what happens with all these cars going everywhere.
Omaki with a big run up to the... Still 3x3. Farley avoids the wall. Seems like everyone's gotten through cleanly.
This is going to be chaos if this holds form.
Don Falconer up there running in that moisture, the darkened groove up in the top side of the racetrack. Cade Bishop neglected to run that line.
We've seen lately that the moisture, while giving you that run, it does make your car way, way looser. People have been hitting the wall frequently. I wonder if drivers are starting to stay clear of that.
Carter Jones already gained some significant ground off that restart. You'll see him right back there. We'll see what position he clocks in at as we take the stripe. But it's going to be Don Falconer leading the first lap.
Caden Bishop looking to his inside right now.
A little bit of run through turn number one. Now he's going to pick to the inside.
James Omaki, definitely a name that you wouldn't see up here, especially considering what he said in multiple interviews. He does not really care about winning these races. He's only here to have fun.
And now to the outside, or the inside in this case, the 37 of Caden Bishop. He's been winless since Season 1 Bristol Dirt. See if he can snap that streak here at Papyrus.
Definitely going to try. I'm not sure if he's going to get the run through the corner. Definitely, if you want to pass on this corner, you have to make the pass in the middle of the corner. You will not get that pass coming off.
I think we'll see some drivers try that slide job later today. In 3 and 4 and 3, but we have yet to see that. Don Falconer keeps control of that lead. As the caution lights are in fact on, we'll see who wins the race back to the stripe. Kyler Scott and Justin Newman seem to be involved in this one. Sydney Allen, Caleb Marinelli.
No, not Sydney.
She wins back to the stripe. Caden Bishop with a run. But it will be the 66 of Don Falconer, our Chili Bowl winner, leading us back to the yellow flag. Followed by Caden Bishop, James Omaki, Paul Donlin, and Ethan Farley, rounding out our top five. There's Kyler Scott, who was our points leader just two races ago, with yet another stroke of bad luck here. Justin Newman also has not had the best of luck here in recent races. He's going to pull up to pit road for some repairs. And so will our number 17 of Kyler Scott.
Wonder what happened between the two of them.
Looks like our replay team is working on getting that, as we'll take a look at these cars. And Don Falconer continues to lead the way here. Followed by Caden Bishop, James Omaki, Paul Donlin, Ethan Farley. Here's our replay. Right now, at the center of your screen, we're going to be focused on the 8 of Zach Stern. As both he and the 44 are going to slide up the racetrack. Just riding the wall a little bit. And there's some contact right there between the 19 and the 8.
Oh boy, Zach Stern got hit a little bit loopy there.
Oh, and almost some contact with Carter Jones. Zach Stern going to keep it going, but right in front of track with the 19 of Justin Newman, a big hit from the 17 of Kyler Scott. Caleb Mariner, like, just barely able to slide through unscathed, and wow, a big hit on that apron from the 57 of Sydney Allen.
No brakes. Trying to go through that corner. This dirt, it's not very fun to try and stop on that dirt.
It's a situation where we've got, excuse me, we've got it on board here.
Oh, look, on board with the 19 of Justin Newman.
Oh yeah, that's just happening all in front of you. You have nowhere you can go.
It's one of those deals where, you know, you've got it, everything's happening so fast that you've only got so little time to react. But with a surface that like this, where you can't really stop as quickly as you'd like to, it's just one of those deals where you've got to hold on and hope for the best.
Yeah, you really cannot. You really cannot alter your direction. You know, it's one of those strategies in dirt racing where you kind of just send it and hope for the best. If you try to stop, you're going in the fence.
Oh, a big hit right there.
I'm looking on that onboard from Kyler Scott right now. Marinelli was able to slow down terrifically. I'm very curious what Kyler Scott's thought process was, because it looked as though he didn't even try to slow down.
I'm not sure if he thought he could shoot the gap or if Marinelli just had more grip on that run in that upper groove.
This is Sydney Allen, I believe, that we're riding with right now.
Right there.
Yeah, just flies right on through.
No look at Caleb, but his excellent ability to avoid this wreck happening right in front of him. Feel the debris flying in his direction.
Oh, wow.
That's a great view of the accident.
I'm very curious. I reiterate, I'm still very curious about what the 17 stop process was. Terrific work by the 15 to get the load down.
There's a slow motion replay. Both the hits taken by the 17. There's the first one to Justin Newman.
I'm willing to bet Kyler Scott's thought process was, oh, he's going to hold the brakes. He'll stay up high. I can go low. And he didn't hold the brakes. So he just kind of, it was too little too late.
I'm very curious because you saw, oh, were you, my apologies, Justin.
I was about to say, I think Sydney Allen maybe thought he could have found an opening that didn't get there in time. So that's what happened there.
I'm very curious because I saw on the inside of Kyler Scott, the 91 of Logan Speed. I'm very curious if perhaps Scott thought there was an opening, but Speed was also coming far too on the inside to to make any sort of move happen, and he was ultimately stuck where it was.
Yeah, probably it was the case. How unfortunate. But pace car lights are off. We're going back green this time.
Yes, sir, they are. As our running order remains the same. Well, see at the tail end of the field. Or not, I guess not. It seems that all drivers involved in that incident are still in that race. I know Kyler Scott is currently on pit road getting some repairs done. Justin Newman might be the same.
Falconer, Bishop, Omaki, Donlin, and Farley running at your top five as we come back to the green line.
And there goes the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series Chevrolet Silverado Pace Truck. Single file all throughout the field as Don Falconer through the Geico restart zone. Green flag is back in the air here at Papyrus. And already looking down low with the 37 of Caden Bishop into turn one.
Wow, got a great restart there. Going to try and get around Falconer here. We'll see what Omaki does, if he stays with his teammate or if he goes with the faster car.
Monkey looking low. He wants second, maybe even a little more from Caden Bishop.
And see how they run going into three and four here.
They are three wide behind him.
85 of KR trying to make a move here.
Caden Bishop with a big gap now. Omaki gonna try to run on the outer group, see if he can get a little bit more speed.
Oh, in the fence. Now, that's what I'm talking about, what Don Falconer did. If you want to try and make a pass to somebody on that outside, you've got to block them before they can get that run going.
Falconer going way, way up the racetrack. Paul Donald trying to gain some positions as well.
Monty losing a lot of momentum after that contact with the fence.
There's three wide racing right there with Tanner Campos. This is towards the edge of the top 10. As he's running the outer groove right now through turn 7, and it's not working out for him as well as he'd hoped.
No, I'm not sure anybody was expecting that to be the right way to go through there.
Luke has almost made their way up into the top 10. That we knew that 62 Ricardo Jones was fast, and he's surely proving it. He's almost within the top 10.
Absolutely.
Here comes Ethan Farley.
Crazy fast as we see Ethan Farley try to bully his way to the second spot.
And all this battling is going to be to the great benefit of Caden Bishop.
Comes Evan to the bottom.
You haven't really seen somebody pull away all day today, but now Caden Bishop is doing that. That 37 Brick Machine, we know Brink has shown some speed recently, some race-winning speed even. But they haven't been able to put it together. Can Caden Bishop finally end that streak?
Oh, watch out, 3-wide going off the corner here. That might end a bed.
They give each other quite good space there.
Yeah, quite clean driving. Not what you expect out of drivers of this caliber.
This is minding his own business. He doesn't want to run up there because he knows that might mean some wall contact.
Caden Bishop now is thinking just firing off clean laps. Do not make any mistakes.
Appears as though they have settled down, and we'll see if anyone within this top few field cars can pull away and at least contest the 37.
I think if anybody can do it, it's this 62 right here, Carter Jones. Had a fast car all day, just kind of been bad luck. Started him really far behind.
Now, Gene, you were just talking about Carter Jones, and you too, James. And now he's working with Seth Peters. And now, with that pass on Paul Donlan, he's going to be into the top 10 a little bit under halfway through this race.
He's still got plenty of time to get all the way back up there. See these guys trying to cycle that. Alan Mooch trying to get the spot here on Don Falconer.
Alan Mooch kind of fell off a cliff. He had an average finish of 7th place in the first 4 or 5 races of the season, leading up to a suspension at the Chili Bowl. And now he's running outside the top 15 in points. He's trying to regather all that lost ground right now. And what a move to the top side he just made.
Absolutely. Probably going to get clear here for 3rd place, I believe that is, yes. Falconer trying to do a crossover here. I'm pretty sure Allen's going to get the run off the corner.
The caution lights are on. Oh, and upside down.
Oh,
Oh, my good God.
That is...
Big wreck in turn 6.
It appeared to
Marinelli, Don Falconer, I'm sorry, Paul Donlan and Logan Speed all caught up in that.
That was...
They come to the line. Caden Bishop's going to lean it back to the yellow, but that 1 second lead is now gone.
That was incredibly violent. I sincerely hope that everyone's okay.
Caden Bishop. Caleb Marinelli was almost involved in that first accident, but this time it's going to do him in. Seems like that car is toast. Paul Donlan obviously done after flipping his race car.
Hard look for Paul Donlan.
Logan Speed's going to continue on. Speed will slow down, let the pace car by. Or pace truck in our case.
Not sure a pace car would do very good on this dirt.
Well, sure, that's why we got our truck. To deal with the off-roading.
Wait and see a replay of what happened there.
And here it is.
Donlan.
It's another case.
Yeah. You saw that cloud of dirt kind of come up. Maybe his suspension just bit and it didn't want to go any more sideways than that.
Clips Nate Wines. Kylie Rider, I think, just barely got away from that.
And here's the contact from the on-rushing Caleb Marinelli. And that banking transition is enough to send him over.
Just the right angle that forced all that. So I'm very curious.
There's the contact
Oh.
additionally from Logan Speed. That's the driver's side door.
That is not good. I hope he's okay.
It was just another one of those deals where, we're getting too antsy and we're wanting to get further in, but in the process, we also slide the cars too much to where we just end up sliding right into the wall. And unfortunately, it causes things like this.
For the full speed replay. Violent roll for that fifth to
Oh,
fall
that's
down there.
even worse. Full speed. Oh, boy.
Oh yeah. This onboard was
Devastating.
Marinelli.
Devastating hit for the hat trick driver.
There it is. Go on board with Logan Speed.
This won't be pretty.
You hear the engine shut off. I don't think you get a slow down in time on that apron.
No, you could tell he definitely tried everything he could. Surprised he went with the shut down the engine idea. That's a good way to usually blow out your transmission, but for some reason
I don't think
it's
he shut it, but rather you just don't hear it as he was trying to get the car slowed down. And he'll go on board with Paul Don, and it's gonna be a ride here, folks.
I'm surprised the camera survived this. Oh yeah, that's Good grief. Brief. Anyway, we're gonna go back green this time. Your
Yes.
top five remains the same. You got Bishop, Farley, Falconer. I can't tell who that is behind, but
Toddy.
that you move for me at your top five.
Yeah. We're getting ready to go back green from our third caution of the day, the second of our main event.
Devastating hit for Paul Dolan. I hope he's all right.
I'm getting ready onto the front straightaway to really Silverado pace truck's gonna hit that hard left onto the pit lane. Caden
Gonna have.
Bishop, Ethan Farley, Don Falconer.
We're
Green
gonna have
flag
what,
back in the air.
five to go here at the line.
And you're right, 5 laps to go in this race. Six maybe? Yeah, 6 laps to go in this race. Falconer looking low.
You got Taddy trying to look underneath him at the same time. Taddy wants to try to get position here, but you got to keep up with Caden Bishop. So we'll see if he tries to be aggressive for second or wait until there's a chance to take two spots in one go.
Into turn three. Caden Bishop with a really fast hot rod here at Papyrus. Put it in the wall though. Now a run for Evan Taddy. Evan Taddy trying to get his first career Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series victory. Can he get it done?
We're starting to break away here, putting on a blanket. Ethan Farley doing everything he can to try and keep up.
Caden Bishop got a really great run off of turn six there. He's going to maintain that lead. But now he's dealing with a little bit more pressure than he's used to. How about Carter Jones in that sixth position? He started 21st in this race, had to go through the B main in which he started third to last. And he is up here battling for a top five.
Absolutely an amazing run by Carter, and he's not looking to slow down, looking for that fifth spot on KR.
5 laps to go. Evan Taddy to the bottom for second.
Probably looking for the bottom. He might get it here going through two and three. He'll get clear here in the middle. We'll see if Falconer can get any kind of run.
There you go. He'll dip his tires into that darker groove. You see that dirt kick up. Now he's going to try his luck to the inside down the hill. And that'll be using the inside in turn three.
Looking for it.
Run a little bit lower there, and he's going to slot right back in line behind that 32. Robin Taddy going to try to get a run off the corner. Great corner there by Caden Bishop. Running really high up without hitting the wall. Taddy's going to try to stick with him. Falconer back to the bottom for second. Ethan Farley and Carter Jones now out of the picture.
These two battling for second. It's only going to let Caden get further and further away.
If they come to four to go, it looks like it's going to be a five-car dogfight for the victory.
These five have just been in a different class all day. See who's going to be able to...
another run.
Carter Jones has been going nowhere but forwards ever since this race has started.
Falconer's going to look low. Caden Bishop slammed the door on him. He's going to slide in right behind him. They get ready to head down the hill.
Carter Jones looking to take that outside lane away from Ethan Farley as they come down to four. Carter Jones looks to the inside now, might be trying to slide Joffre there for third.
Oh, but Farley. A contact. Caden Bishop going to run really high up the racetrack now. Going to stay right in that first lane or that darker track section.
Yeah, really close to the fence there. Don Falconer trying everything he can to muster up a run here. I just don't think he has the power underneath that hood to get there.
Look through the field right now. Caden Bishop, Don Falconer have been the two strongest cars of the main event.
Falconer's going to try it here. I'm not sure if he's going to get anywhere with it, though.
To the inside in turn number one. Has he got a nose underneath? Bishop's going to slam the door on him.
Carter Jones got around Evan Toddy for fourth. Going to try and look for third, second, and maybe first here. He's still got plenty of time to do it.
Falconer's going to look low once again. To the inside.
He's got his nose underneath him.
Behind him.
But that 37's got some incredible straight line speed. Three wide for second.
That's going to give Caden a massive run.
And Carter Jones. And wow, both the 0 and the 62 are going to get by the 66 of Falconer. Ethan Farley to second with a double overtake maneuver.
An awesome job here by these top five, all trying to battle for position. Here comes Ethan. He's got a lot of speed.
Into turn seven. Brand new contender for that second spot. Can Ethan Farley show Caden Bishop what's for?
And you see here as they're coming two to go at the line.
Farley's going to peek low. Doesn't quite have the run he needs. Now he does, but no. Caden once again slamming the door on him. Carter Jones into the picture.
Farley
looks low again. Carter Jones looking lower.
That move forced Bishop up the track.
Getting ready to head down the hill. Farley to the inside of Caden Bishop. Side by side for the lead. Into turn three.
There they go. This is probably going to be the run that decides it.
Farley on the outside. Bishop with Farley a big gap run on that bottom. Caden Bishop has been excellent so far in clean air leading this race. He has not looked back ever since he took the lead off that set, off that first restart today. Carter Jones now looking for second. A And he's got a great run through turn 7.
Carter Jones taking away second. He's got one lap to chase down Caden. Can he do it?
The speed, they come out of the front straightaway. Jones looking low. White flag. One more time around at Papyrus.
To the inside of the 37. Jones is going to look. The speed the 62 has had. He's not letting the 37 close the door. To the inside goes Carter Jones.
Side by side, Carter Jones has not won in the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series since Orange County of last season. Bishop, not since Bristol Dirt. They're both looking to end tremendous winless droughts as Carter Jones, for the first time today, is going to take the lead.
Carter's got clear. He's just got to hold on to it.
This is incredible. Don Falconer has now put himself back in the picture. He's on the tail of the 37. Here they come off the massive banked corner. No moves.
They're both into the wall. Bishop with a big run off of turn number 3. Carter Jones going to pull ahead. Caden Bishop with a few more chances now. Carter Jones going to run in that dirt groove.
The door has been left open. To the inside.
There's Bishop. To the inside. He's going to have one more chance.
Billy gets there.
The straight line speed on this 62 is unparalleled. The 37 is going to need to get him in the corners, I feel.
He's right there. Bishop's right there. Where will he make his move? He looks to the inside. But he's run out of straightaway at Carter Jones for the first time in Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series history. He's going to sweep the mains and win at Papyrus.
That was terrific. That was an incredible performance. Comes back from a stroke of just horrific luck in his heat, wins the B main on pure speed, and just comes from the back and wins on raw speed. This is absolutely incredible. What a performance.
You said it. The third victory of the season for Tau Racing comes from the 62 of Carter Jones and the NDSU machine. And what a drive it was.
You know, it's really ironic. I was sitting here trying to watch my monitor. My monitor quit out on me, so I was just kind of watching over Richie's shoulder. Somebody's shoulder. I was watching over somebody's shoulder.
Oh.
You got nice shoulders, DG.
Triumph for Carter Jones, but no doubt heartbreak and frustration for the 37 of Caden Bishop. One of the fastest cars all day and had it until the very end when he just got outbeaten by a car that just happened to be very much faster than his was.
Carter Jones powering all the way back to front, not once but twice today.
Just going to want that one back, but now it's Carter Jones' turn to celebrate here at Papyrus with our Joan camera. Let's see what Carter Jones can do.
My monitor is still out.
That's a shame.
Alright, he's doing some donuts, but he really isn't kicking up a lot of particles here. Seems to be a common issue.
Would appear that way, yes.
Is Carter Jones going to back it up towards the start-finish line? This is his second victory in the series. His first of season 2.
Destroy his car in the process.
I'm not sure the boss, Zach Stern, is going to be too happy about that one.
This will just wait and see.
But Carter Jones has been in the points battle. He's in the top 10 in points right now. And he is within one race of points leader Ethan Farley, who also had a fantastic day, so it'll be interesting to see how those shape out. And then Carter Jones is going to call it quits for the burnouts. An incredible drive from that 62 machine, going from worst to first to win. And for the first time in history, he's going to sweep both the A and the B main here at Papyrus, Carter Jones. And what a thriller it was.
Indeed.
Special thanks to my commentators up in the booth here, Jamison O'Monkey and Giancarlo Urenda, for joining me in the booth here at Papyrus. That'll do it for the ninth race of the season for the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series. Make sure to tune in next time when we go racing at the Williams Grove Speedway. Thanks everyone for watching. Let's take a look at today's race results.